Let's look into how to make roads with Unity Splines 2.5. Alright, there are two ways to make roads. The first way is to actually go to the package manager and inside the Splines package, go to samples and then import the samples. Make sure that you have also imported shader graph as well. Now over onto the examples, we can go to runtime and there's this script called LoftRoadBehaviour. So if we create a spline like this and then drag and drop our LoftRoadBehaviour, you can see that it generates a road for us. And it's good, it's okay, but it has its own drawbacks. Firstly, if we go over to here and then check selection wire, you can see the triangles of this mesh. We can increase the segments per meter to increase the resolution of the generated spline. I'll set it to 3, which will give more detail for stronger curves. And we can repeat this texture by increasing this texture scale. So I can set it to 10. And if you zoom in, we can see that the texture gets repeated, which is something that you may want. Additionally, this script has a great feature to adjust the width of the created road mesh. We can add widths here, and this width will be based on the distance along the spline. The default value doesn't really matter. We can add data points. So in this case, let's say we can add 3 data points, and because it is based on spline distance, we can specify a distance. So let's say 3. You can see that a blue thing appeared over here. That's 3 units from the start. We can also create a point on 6, and then we can add one at 9. And the default value of 3, let's set this to 1. And now you can see what happens. For this, let's set this to 1.5. And then from here, let's set it back to 1. So you can see what we have achieved. And just to make things easier, we can click on this button to manually edit this thing whenever we like it. Cool. So we can adjust the width of the road dynamically wherever we want, which is one big advantage when working with this LoftRoadBehaviour script. Okay. But the downside of this is that it generates too much faces. So for example, let's say this area here is completely stretched out, and in fact let's select both of them and then hit linear so that we get a straight road. Arguably we do not need this much vertices just for this straight line, which means this whole method is not really optimized, but it is what it is. It has some other cool features which we can work with. The second way to make roads is by creating custom script, and I have made one for you. If we go to the GitHub link in the description, we can download this zip file and then open the Spline Mesh Unity package here. And there we go. We have this package. You can uncheck example if you don't want the custom meshes that comes along with this package. Just for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm just going to enable it and then hit import. You generally need only the scripts folder. Okay. Let me just duplicate this spline here to show you how things are done, and then remove all of these components so that we can start from fresh. There are two important scripts here. One is Spline Mesh and the other one is Spline Mesh Resolution. For roads, we will be using Spline Mesh. Spline Mesh Resolution is best used for things like railway tracks and conveyor belts. We will look into it in the next video. So let's just click on the spline. I'll name it Spline Mesh 1. And to that, let's just add the Spline Mesh script. And it automatically adds a mesh filter and a mesh renderer for you. Over on the example, I have provided some mesh and textures on the example scene. You can look into it and learn from how I did it over there. This package ideally works best with blend files. It does work with FBX and OBJ files, but you have to do some tweaking around of things. So for this script, I'm going to use the blend files. So this algorithm works with custom meshes. So if we open it up in Blender, the only thing that you need to take care of is the origin point. We need to set the origin point at the center like this here, and then the mesh should go outwards from the origin point, symmetrical to a particular axis. So in this case, the origin point is here and the mesh goes outwards along the positive Y axis. And if you go to edit mode, you can see that this mesh is subdivided inside Blender. Okay, you need to have the mesh subdivided. The origin point should be at the center and the mesh should go outwards either on the positive X axis or the positive Y axis. Okay, that is the only prerequisite, which means we can add stuff like sidewalks, pavements and stuff if you want to. Because it's completely made in Blender, we can just add that if you want, which is not an option in the other case. So this allows complete customization. Back in Unity on mesh renderer, we need to firstly specify the materials. So in this blend file, I have a road material here. I'm just going to drag and drop it. And then if you go down, this is the spline mesh script. Firstly, it asks for a spline container, which is the spline container here. We can just drag and drop this. Instead, there's a handy button called self. We can click that and it automatically assigns references. Then we need to specify a mesh, which is going to be this mesh of the road here. Cool. We can give it a name, and I'm just going to give it spline mesh by default. It doesn't really matter. And this is the most important thing, the forward axis. Currently it is set to Y. We can choose between X and Y. It does not work with Z axis. So the forward axis is the axis along which this thing should repeat, which is the Y axis in this case. And we can leave everything else at default and hit generate. Now what happened here is the mesh is divided based on the subdivisions that we have added in Blender, and it is much more optimized compared to the other one. You can see both of them in action here, but over here you can see that the straight roads has way less geometry compared to the other one, which is just insane, right? It does not have the other feature like manipulating road width dynamically. If you want me to add that feature, please do let me know and I'll update the package. We can, however, deal with things like offset. So we can add an offset like 0.1 and hit generate again. And it is going to just get rid of the weird blue line over there. We don't need to mess around with rotation in this case, but we can change the scale X to be like 2. And if we hit generate again, we can see that the mesh just gets bigger. And for the textures, we have this property called UV resolution. This is an integer. We can set it to like 10 and hit generate again. And you can see that the UVs are also repeated along with the road. There is this checkbox called uniform UVs. If we uncheck that, the UVs will also get stretched along with the stretching of the mesh. So this is useful if you want things like dirt roads and stuff, where you want the dirt to also kind of, you know, stretch along with the mesh. I'm going to turn that off. And yeah, that's how we make roads. So the advantage is that we can have very good detail by just closing the two spline points together, and we can move this as far away as possible in areas where we don't want much geometry. So this is going to be a very good optimization. If you want to smooth things out, make sure to select the knot and set it to auto. Okay, so if you go to the spline edit mode and let's say we turn this back to auto, you can see that the smoothness is retained and it works really well, and we can move this around and the spline gets generated. We can turn this off by just clicking on this blue button here, and if we turn it off, we can move the spline without generating the mesh, and we can hit generate. This is going to save a lot of in-editor performance. So you might want to turn this off if your road is too big or something, so that it does not keep on generating. All right, and there we go. That's roads inside Splines 2.5 package in Unity. Just as a side note, if we were to work with FBX files, let's say if we drag and drop this FBX mesh and let's set the scale back to 1, you can see that the mesh goes tiny. This is because Unity automatically scales down FBX files by 100 when you import them. An easy fix is to just offset the scale by 100 and it's going to generate the mesh back. So if you want twice the width, you can set it to 200 and hit generate again. So that's how you work with FBX files. This is not going to increase the scale up top. This is just going to increase the mesh vertex distances based on the scale. And yeah, you can play around with the offset values. With this, we can create things like roller coasters or conveyor belts with legs and stuff, which is pretty cool. And finally, if you're working with OBJ files, just drag and drop the OBJ mesh file and then set the scale back to 1. If you hit generate, nothing works. This is because of the access problems when it comes to OBJ files. You could fix it manually in Blender and stuff whenever you're exporting it. But in case if it doesn't work, we can just offset the rotation X to 90, and this is going to come back and work exactly like the blend file. And yeah, that's it. That's pretty much it for roads. We can work with mesh colliders here. The best thing is that we have much fewer vertices compared to the other one, but we don't have the custom width thingy on the second one. If you want me to add that feature, I'll see what I can do. If you're interested in how we can set up railway tracks or conveyor belts, you can check out this video. Until then, stay safe, take care, see ya, bye-bye.